So tonight is all about school-wide positive behavior system. They are the ones who put on this lovely variety show that I am so honored to be emceeing tonight. The money is going towards school-wide positive behavior system, which promotes positive activity throughout the school, helps with our pep rallies, helps with activities that we do here, helps with prizes, much like the Spark parking space that we have out in the front, which is very nice if you ever get the chance to use it. So, with all that out of the way, let us begin, because we have almost double the acts that we had last year, so there's not enough time for me, so y'all can take a big breath of relief right now, because you're not going to be seeing as much of me as you did last year. So, woo! Yeah! All right. Starting off, we have Maya Fulton and Katie Musset. They are both freshmen, and they will be singing What Is This Feeling?
What is this feeling so sudden and new?
I felt the moment I laid eyes on you.
My pulse is rushing.
My head is reeling.
My face is flushing. What is this feeling? Fervid as a flame. Does it have a name? Yes. Loathing. Unadulterated loathing.
Or your face.
Your voice.
Let's just say, I loathe it all. Every little trait, however small, makes my very flesh begin to crawl. The simple utter loathing, there's a strange exhilaration in such total detestation. It's so pure, it's so strong.
Keep three. Come on, girls.
Right, that was Fuka Onishi. She is new to the school this year. She's a foreign exchange student, and I asked her backstage before I came out here. I was like, hey, Fuka, how do you say, you know, the town that you're from in Japan? So I'm going to try and say this as well as I can. She's from Saitama, Japan, and she came here as a foreign exchange student, and if you think that you've seen her before, she was in the fall show here, and she's going to be in the musical in the spring, so come out and see her because she is very, very talented, and she also has a great voice. So give it up for Fuka one more time. All right. Our next performance is Emily Harris. Emily just took first chair, second violin at District Orchestra, so please welcome Emily.
Thank you.
right, that was the sign language club for Bellefonte High School here doing that rendition of Star Street Beautiful, which is absolutely beautiful. Our next performer is Reba Jabko. She is going to be performing a poem that she wrote. I heard this at the dress rehearsal and it's absolutely beautiful. It's very timely, it's very original, and it's overall, like, you're just going to love it. So here is Reba Jabko, and she's going to be performing a hurt, her own poem.
I tell you to make your walls, make your defense, to make your life. Find your place and stand. Stand for those buildings. Stand for your friends, family, people. People are people no matter what, whether they are black or white, blonde or brunette, small or tall, rich or poor, popular or not. We are all equally as important because we all are unique, because we all still have a heart.
Experiencing some technical difficulties with the next performer, so they sent me out here without my clipboard. So I'm just going to introduce what the next performance is going to be. The next performance is going to be 16/1/17 from the hit musical The Sound of Music. And it's really cute because the girl who is singing here, Megan Irwin, she also took first chair at district chorus, so she can sing beautifully. And if you want to see her, you can come see her also in the musical this spring. She is 16, and the person who is singing with her, Carson Bethel, is 17. And they are singing 16 going on 17 from the musical Sound of Music, which you already know because I just told you. So, they go ready to give it up for Carson and Megan.
Late blue on an empty stage.
All right, that was Megan and Carson singing 16 going on 17 from The Sound of Music. Next up, our next performer is very nervous. This is the first time that this performer is performing their act in front of a live audience. And it's kind of hard for this performer to do this act for 2.5 minutes or however long this person wants to take without losing focus and messing up. So encourage him if he messes up. He's very nervous back there, but he's very good at what he does. He schools me in it. I tried to get better at it through him teaching me, and I just can't do it. So here is Payne McCartney. Thank you for the backup music, Eddie. But that was Payne McCartney juggling for the first time in front of an audience. Payne and I have 10th period together, and we had a study hall today. And I was just like, Payne, what are you going to do? And he was like, well, I'm going to juggle. And for 45 minutes, he juggled, preparing for this. So I think it turned out well for him. He's very good at what he does, and that was pretty fun. And I cannot do it as well as he does, so don't ask. Our next performance is going to be their own version of Baby It's Cold Outside. This is Anna Kate Scott and Drew Nixdorf.
The mic's on.
Yeah,
it's fine.
Cool. I'm gonna open this too, so it's ready. Okay. All right.
I really can't stay.
Listen to that fireplace.
So really, I'd better scurry.
Beautiful, please don't.
Well, maybe just a half a drink more.
Put some records on while I'm
pouring. The neighbors might think.
Maybe it's bad out there.
What's in this drink?
It's just water.
Okay. I wish I knew how to break this spell.
I'll take your hat.
Looks well.
Mind if I move it?
At least I'm gonna say that I tried.
What's the sense of hurting my pride?
I really can't stay.
Baby, don't hold out.
Baby, it's cold outside. So what's in this food, really, though? Flavored water or something?
Yeah, it's a blueberry. Like the smell of your hair.
simply must go.
Baby, it's cold outside.
The answer is no.
Baby, it's cold outside.
This welcome has been so very weird.
Look out the window at that beer.
Will be suspicious.
Gosh, your lips look delicious.
My brother will be there at the door.
Waves upon a tropical storm.
My maiden aunt's mind is
Gosh, your lips look delicious.
Maybe just 2 minutes more.
All right, I'll take it.
I've gotta get home.
Baby, you'll freeze out there.
Lend me your coat.
It's up to your knees out there.
You've really been a thrill when you touch, but don't you see?
How can you do this thing to me?
There's bound to be talk tomorrow.
Think of my lifelong
at
sorrow.
Be plenty of
when you get pneumonia, it's baby, don't hold out, baby. Cold, baby, it's cold outside.
There's a boy who works at Starbucks who is very inspirational. Yes, he's very inspirational because of many things. I come in at 8:11 and he smiles and says, "How are you?" When he smiles and says, "How are you?" I could swear my heart grows wings. So today at 8:11, I decided I should meet him. I decided I should meet him in a formal, proper way. So today at 8:11, as he smiled and said, "How are you?" I said, "Fine, and my name's Emma." And he softly answered, "Hey." And I said, "My name is Emma, and thank you for the extra foam." And he said his name was Taylor, which provides the inspiration for this poem. Taylor, the latte boy, bring me Java, bring me joy. Oh, Taylor, the latte boy, I love him, I love him, I love him. So I'd like to get my nerve up to recite my poem musical. He would like the fact it's musical because he plays guitar. So today at 8:11, Taylor told me he was playing in a band down in the village of a basement of a bar. And he smoothly flipped the lever to prepare my double latte. But for me, he made it triple, and he didn't think I knew. But I saw him flip the lever, and for me, he made it triple. And I knew that triple latte meant that Taylor loved me too. I said, "What time are you playing? And thank you for the extra skim." He said, "Keep the 355, cause this triple latte was on him." Taylor, the latte boy, bring me Java, bring me joy. Oh, Taylor, the latte boy, I love him, I love him, I love him. I used to be the kind of girl who'd run when love rushed towards her. But finally a voice whispered, "Love can be yours if you step up to the counter and order." Taylor, the latte boy, bring me Java, bring me joy. Oh, Taylor, the latte boy, I love him, I love him, I love him. So many years my heart has waited. Who'd have thought that love could be so caffeinated? Taylor, the latte boy, I love him, I love him, I love him. I love him, I love him, I love him.
All right. So the act before that was Grace Files playing Somewhere Over the Rainbow on the violin. Give it up for her real quick for me. She's very good, a part of our orchestra here. The act that you just saw was Ryan Lidgett, who we will talk about later on in the show, and Emma Horderman, who is a district placeholder for district choir, and she will be moving on to region chorus in a couple weeks. She's also in the musical this spring, if you want to come see the musical this spring. She'll be playing Miss Sandra. She's very good. I've seen her in practice. She's very, very good. This next act, I'm a little jealous about. Over the summer, I got into magic tricks and cards, and I went and actually visited the Museum of Magic in New York City. And this act pretty much puts me to shame in anything that I've ever learned. So here is Alex Coppola with a little help from Mr. Maris. Magic.
One, two, three. All right. I'm out here, and I would like Mr. Maris, also known as Louie from the Wrong Direction, soon to be performing out here in second session. Yes.
Right.
All right. It's my turn right now. Okay. Do me a favor. No doubles. No doubles. It's in new deck order. This is a brand new deck. Okay. Now, I don't really need a joker, so I'll just get rid of them. First thing to do, every single trick. Come on. There it goes. All right. Shuffle the deck. Every single trick. Okay. This next one. That looked fairly weaved.
Yes, it does.
There's not a single card left out. Okay. Now, I'm gonna have you pick a card, but make sure it's towards the middle, okay?
Right.
Touch a card, doesn't matter that card, any card. You want that card, you like that card. You're gonna take that card and do me a favor and take this three of hearts, and you're gonna do me a favor and sign it. Yes, I do. Okay. All right. Now, there's only one card in the city, anyway. In the entire world, it's like this, okay? I'm gonna take that card. Put it in the middle. Strictly in the middle. Okay? It goes in the middle. This little part right here. I'd like to test this out a bit. Take that two cards, put it in the middle, push that in for me in there. Okay? Done. Do me a favor and snap your fingers. Costume every time. Now, people say that magic is all sleight of hand. There's no, no magic. Well, what's the fun of saying that, right? Now, this card is brand new to me. Okay? I'm gonna take that card. Put as many cards onto it. I got two spots on it, okay? Now, I want you to do me a favor. Snap your fingers again. This card, let's see if it actually does. There it is. See how magic is, it's like the three of diamonds, so it switched suits, you know? All right, now I'm gonna take this card, three of hearts. There's no snapping involved, just... There's this card right here. He's back. Now, can I take... Now, here's his card, right? Clearly on top. Mr. Maris, push that in for me. Right on top. Again. Now, all you folks out there, I'd like you to do me a favor. I'd like for all you to snap your fingers on a count of three. One. Count of three. One, two, three. Don't jump to the top. Obviously not. Okay? Now, we're going to take this out. I'm going to snap my fingers. Ready? Don't jump to the top. Obviously not. Okay? You guys are going to snap your fingers again on the count of three. One, two, three. Don't jump to the top. Obviously not, because Mr. Maris here is in control. He calls him every single time. Mr. Maris, would you do me a favor and snap your fingers? Jump to the top. Now, I'm going to go as far as I'm going to bend the card. Okay. As you can see, it is bent. Okay. Ready? Do me a favor and snap your fingers on the edge. Jumps to the top. Now, before the show, I made a little bit of a prediction. Mr. Maris, do me a favor. Here's his prediction. Do me a favor. Ladies and gentlemen, I predict that the participant will choose a card. Ladies and gentlemen, how good am I? Oh my gosh, actually, I predicted the Three of Hearts. Three of Hearts. Ladies and gentlemen, that is the Three of Hearts. The same thing. That's all I got. Thank you. Cheers.
That was pretty crazy. Better than anything that I could do. Alex, if you don't know, Alex is on the wrestling team. And the wrestling team just had a huge success this season by winning the Mountain League for what I heard was the very first time. So give it up for the wrestling team. They're a record 17-1. They're going to the district duels this Saturday where they will be facing multiple other teams from around the area. So best of luck to them and Alex as well. Yes. The next performer is Hallie Mitchell. She also is moving on to Region Chorus as she placed at districts this past January. And she's singing her own song, an original, called Fifth Street. It's very beautiful. I hope you enjoy it.
Has drifted away. When you're gone, there's only storm clouds getting ready for a hurricane. Now what do I do? Should I stand here and wait here for you, or do I leave? How you left to me standing in the pouring rain on Fifth Street in our little hometown, standing here as all of the rain falls down. There's a tear on my face. Oh, but you couldn't tell. You already filled my place with some southern belle. Now that you're gone, the flowers won't smell. since you turned around and you walked away. Now that you're gone and found a new girl, you'll start a new life far, far, far away. And I won't forget all the memories that we have been made yet. We could be standing in the pouring rain on Fifth Street in a little hometown, standing here as all of the rain falls down. You looked in my eyes, but you couldn't tell me the truth. Never said our goodbyes, but I don't need you to. Now that you're gone, I'll be at peace. It's hard now, but I will move on. When you're gone, maybe I'll find some joy in my life. Now that you're gone.
So, I'm not really big into rapping, you know, it's not my main thing, but I figured, you know, I'd give it a shot, you know, just, if any of you are familiar with Little Dicky, yeah. Cue it. Bruh. Bruh, BPD. Bruh, aka Spank Daddy. Everybody in the blue plaids like a dope mean. I chasing tigers out back like an Australian. I make them drawings on the Mac like I'm the Steve Jobs. Now these days his brother's coming back for sick teeth. How do you think I've been making this spill? With these scoots and jars in a canvas so frail. I've been doing this for 70 years on sale. I'm the best diggy dog up in the font celeste here. On that note, I got the homies saying, hey, what up? The zombie stuff. You don't like getting this unless you pay, yeah. But I'm great, shut up. Flow in the debate with stars. So I'm in shape that I can eat the walk. Got two kittens here at home. No, trying to bet them, but they frisky and they run. No, you know my honeysuckle sweet with the girls. Guy, you know you catch my honey. It's being fly, bro. What do I do? Going hard, being canvas on the cool and blue. On the canvas, make the best of acrylic and screw. Whoever thinks they can vex my precision in blue. Plasma, pen, ink, copyrighted too. All news you hear, it ain't cut it. I'm better than Picasso, I've done it. Biking like a mountain man up that summit. Put on these mittens, I'm gonna go up in the hole for them, be busting the billions. I'll never be quitting, my art is so fly, you be listening to the runs I'm putting up on the ceiling. Like your mom in the kitchen when she washing dishes. I be up in my bedroom, rocking out to the biscuit. You never get my good brother right, and never be quitting, cause every day I'm always trying for the life I be living. Man, catch them flies with honey, being funny, making money, skies are sunny, always running.
Somebody once told me the world is gonna roll me. I ain't the sharpest tool in the shed.
Hey, get my name, cause making teas, but I don't give a fire truck if you ain't paying me. I'd be doing this for fun, and if you hating me, I'd be like, son, I tell you what, I'm the BPD. Band slam, clapping the sands, clapping the hands, going ham, football games is grand, kicking the stand, we'll be jammed with the steering plan, man, going ham, be the man with the van, man, tell it to your friend, man.
Thank you.
Thank you. That was fun. If anybody wants to cake this too, signature. Sweet.
Hey, that was him rapping for the first time in front of anybody. Let's give it up for him again. And Hallie Mitchell wrote that song. Like, she wrote that song. All right, this is the part in the show where y'all get to stand up and take a break and stretch out. It is a 10-minute intermission. The women's bathrooms are out these doors and up the ramp over here. The men's bathrooms are out these doors and up the stairs on this side. I missed something out there, right? You're good? Okay. And we will be back in 10 minutes. Let me give you a little forward show of what is coming up next. We have a boy band who is... It's pretty good. We have more Broadway music. We have the drum line. We have a Napoleon Dynamite dance. We have a lot more coming up in the second act. We'll see you in 10 minutes.
Thank you.
singing from a show that just turned, I believe, 12 or 19. I know there's two different numbers, but I know it's the same. That's their number on Broadway. They will be singing Just Can't Wait to Be King from Lion King. Thank you.
it's your fault.
No, it isn't, because I gave it to my mom.
So it's her fault.
No,
it
isn't.
I should not be to obtain your shoes.
So then when it goes, what happens in the beat?
It's you.
That whole game of July. Oh, dear, but I never knew it,
so
I never knew.
So it's your fault.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, so that was Avery and Brees and Caitlin, and I have a special announcement since they're all up here. It's somebody's birthday up here. Somebody's birthday up here. It's Caitlin Allman's birthday. So I thought it would be really funny. People in the back, you can come on out now. We're going to sing Happy Birthday to her. Because we all have talent here. We're all going to sing to her. And she's going to stay out here. It's going to be great. Here come people. Come on over, people in the back. Okay. Okay. I really don't know how this is going to go because I don't know the starting page for Happy Birthday. But I'm going to hold this mic as far away as I can. And then we'll sing, okay?
So I'll count to it. We'll go 3, 2, 1, and then we'll sing
Happy Birthday. Okay, good.
I'm muting your mic, Jordan, just so you know. Don't want to let that on these people. So, you're welcome.
Thank you. Okay, ready? 3, 2, 1.
Happy birthday.
Okay, so that was Feel This Moment. Feel This Moment. Yes, yes, it was. And it was her birthday, and thank you all for participating in that song. Y'all sounded great from up here. Our next act is already out of the stage, and they surrounded me, so I'm going to stop talking. Here is Mason and Hunter, and they are going to be singing A Day in the Life.
There we go. Okay.
appearance this coming month, singing For Good from the hit musical Wicked. Give it up for him. I was also being accompanied by Ryan Lidget, and we will talk about him later on in the show. The next act performed last year, he was a huge hit. He's very freakishly good at this, and it really freaks me out, but he's like amazing, and it doesn't, like, at the rehearsal, I was just like, did he put his cell phone up to like the microphone, and then just kind of like stand there? He doesn't use his cell phone. This is all natural talent, this is John Meyer, he's awesome. I'm going to need your help to tell me what I'm doing wrong, what I'm doing right. All right. Thank you. So first, I'm going to go, I thought drumline, the performance was eh. So I thought I could do what they can do. I mean, drums can't be that hard, can they? Shuffle the cards.
What I want you to do is I want you to pick out a color, any card, any card you want, really anything. Go ahead. Now, give me the card. All right. Let me shuffle these. Human does. Just breathe. Just relax. Simple. Breathing. It's fine. Alright. Sorry about that, I guess. Let me just.
For the kids, March 25th. So please generously donate. It's a very good cause. Obviously, the Penn State Dance Marathon raises a lot of money every single year. Actually, they raise like $12 million. So it's a pretty good deal. We're pretty honored to be a part of it. Pretty lucky to have that opportunity here. So please generously donate, and thank you all for your support. And the next act is going to be Sierra Huntington. And after that, we'll be Ryan Lynch, but I'll come out and we'll talk about him a little bit. So, enjoy Sierra Huntington.
piece of bass. Give it up one more time for Ryan. And Mrs. Jay Zimmerman on the piano as well. That was the last performance of the night. So just a couple quick thank yous. I'd like to thank School Wide Positive Behavior System for putting this whole thing on. So thank you for them. Thank you for stage crew, who is all back there and helping with pianos and microphones and everything else. And if you hadn't seen this, why did you vote? So we're gonna get that fixed soon. And we'd also like to thank Video Production. They filmed the whole entire thing with three different cameras, so shout out to Video Production for that. They did a lot of hard work. Overall, thank you all for coming out. Enjoy your ride home, drive safe, and see you next time. Hold this wall.